Well, tell me about yourself. I confused what to say. My name is or myself. Should I add first Miss, Mrs. or Mr.? No, no. Yes, yes. Oh, help, dear master. The throat gets so I feel like thirst. And they ask, do you have thirst? I stumble, weighed by sweat. It would be better to have next date. Good morning, everyone. I, Amrapali Modak, on behalf of Nagpur Shikshan Mandal, Sri Binzani City College, Nagpur, invite you all on this 8th session of career-oriented certificate course in communication skills and personality development organized by the Department of English. Respected Principal Dr. Sujit Maitre sir, the guest for today's session, Dr. Rupali Bhave ma'am, the head of the Department of English, Dr. Shende sir, the organizing team members, respected teachers, and dear friends. I welcome you all for this 8th day session on interview skills. Future is waiting for us with new opportunities. Apart from degrees, we have to prepare ourselves with skills, and we found students are always worried about interview. Enough knowledge, but haven't communication skills, presentations, and confidence. So to solve this problem today, we have with us Dr. Rupali Bhave ma'am as a guest. She is going to be interacting with you on interview skills. Dr. Bhave is a Master of Arts in English from Amravati University. She has secured second merits in MA Linguistics from Rashtrasanta Tukaroji Maharaj, Nagpur University, Nagpur. She also has SET qualified and has awarded PhD in 2018. She has 16 years of teaching experience, and her 14 research papers have published in national and international journal, national seminar, and international conferences also. She also has published her book, The Importance of Communication in Modern Drama, in 2019. Apart from this, she also has done additional BA in Marathi literature as well as BA. She is hardworking, sincere, and dedicated always for her work. She is always eager to learn new things in the field of knowledge. I heartily welcome you, ma'am. So without wasting the time, I invite Dr. Rupali Bhave ma'am to begin the session.
Thank you, Amrapali ma'am. Firstly, I would like to express my gratitude to Dr. Sujit Maitre sir, the principal of SB City College, Dr. A.M. Shende sir, head of the English department in SB City College, and Dr. Pranjali Kani ma'am, IQC coordinator, SB City College, and the entire staff members of English department. Dr. Rupali Bhave, welcome to all participants in my live class lecture. Today my topic is interview skills. Before proceeding to my topic, I want to share what is the origin of interview. The term interview is derived from French words enter, go. Enter means to go through, and go means views. In this way, interview is a process to go through views. The term has been derived from the French word enter, go, that means to glimpse or to see each other. By definition, it means a meeting for obtaining information by questioning a person or persons. Whenever I select this topic, the first question arose in my mind, what is an interview exactly? The word interview refers to a conversation between interviewer and interview. A panel interview. Interview is a face-to-face interaction between two persons for a particular purpose, and interview is a purposeful exchange of ideas, the answering of questions and communications between two or more persons. A selection interview is a selection procedure designed to predict future job performance on the basis of applicants' oral response to oral inquiries. This picture shows a panel interview. A panel interview is also called a board interview. Next, let us discuss our definition of an interview. An interview is a presentation of self for the interviewer, the interview, and the organization. There are three types of interviews. First is unstructured interviews, second is semi-structured interviews, and the third is structured interviews. What are interview skills? Interview skills are the actions that candidates take to achieve success in the interviews. There are three stages of interview. When you go to interview, you have to face three stages. First is before the interview, second is during the interview, and the third is after the interview. What should you improve before interview? Firstly, you have to elevate your communication skill. Though you are very talented person, but you have lack of communication skill, you don't crack your interview successfully. And that's why you have to elevate your communication skill firstly. Then you have to elevate listening skill, because listening skill is a important part of interview. If you have a lackness of listening skill, you will not give answer of the questions properly and rightly. And that's why you have to elevate your listening skill also. Then you have to elevate speaking skill, because fluently speaking is a important role in interview. Without a speaking skill, you will not express your ideas, views through your speaking, and that's why you have to elevate your speaking skill. And next, you have to show presence of mind. When you will go interview, sometimes interviewer asks some questions, but you have no answer at that time. But according to your presence of mind, you can crack that answer at that time. Next, intellectual ability. You have to elevate your intellectual ability, because in most of the interviews, you have to ask so many intellectual ability questions. There are so many questions related to intellectual ability, and that's why you must elevate your intellectual ability. Then you have to keep confidence, and but not overconfidence. Whenever you have to go interview, before that time you have to keep your confidence and not be overconfident at that time. Next, you have to keep awareness of subjects which your interview is related, which is subject, and that's why you have to know about the subject knowledge. You have to awareness of that subject and technical knowledge also, because today's world, today's age is a computer age, and that's why you have to improve your technical knowledge also. Next, update your general knowledge also, because in most of the interviews you have been asked some general knowledge questions, questions which are related with general knowledge, and that's why what is current affairs in the world, you have to know about that, and that's why you should update your general knowledge and current affairs knowledge. Next, you have to know about the analytical thinking. What Amrapali ma'am has told you, what is analytical thinking, and that's why before going to interview, you have to maintain our analytical thinking, and that's why analytical thinking is a most important part in the interview. Next, you have to maintain your group discussion skill also. Harsha ma'am also told yesterday that how to do group discussion, and that's why you have to elevate your group discussion skill in that interview, because most of the interviews are held as a panel interview or board interview, and that's why you have to know about the group discussion skill. Next, you have to know elaboration skill or a presentation skill, and that's why you have command or you have ability to show your presentation through your personality development and through your speaking level, and that's why you have to knowledge of elaboration skill. Next, you have to maintain fluency on language. Also, without fluency, you cannot crack interview, and that's why I want to tell you be elevate your fluency on language, which language you have selected. Please elevate that language. What should you do before interview? Whenever we have to go interview, what should you do preparation before interview? Firstly, find out the information about the organization or institutions or company where you have to give interview. Next, secondly, keep ready your job profile. Check whether you have taken interview letter, ID proof, essential documents, and whether you have make your job profile according to requirements in the advertisement, and that's why keep ready your job profile according to the requirements in the advertisement, and it is the most important part in interview, and that's why before interview you should keep ready your job profile according to the requirements in the advertisement. Update your CV or resume according to advertisement. You have to update your CV, resume. It has been said that resume is a mirror of your personality. Do you know CV or resume is a mirror of your personality, because it shows how you develop your personality, and that's why resume is a very important part in interview. So update your CV or resume, all requirements which are shown in the advertisement, according to that requirements you should be maintain or update your CV or resume and qualification also. Next, practice interviews by arranging mock interviews. You should practice interviews by arranging mock interview, because firstly you have feel something fearful in mind, but you will make a practice interviews by arranging mock interview, your mind will be free of fear, and that's why you can give your interview confidently and clearly. Next, you have to maintain your good hygiene, because it has been said that health is the wealth, and that's why maintain your good hygiene, prepare mentally, because without mentally preparation you cannot give your interview. That's why maintain your good hygiene and dress professionally with comfortable. Whenever you will go interview, dress professionally and formal dress and comfortable dress, because if you wore tight dress, you will not feel comfortable, and that's why your dress must be professionally but formal with comfortable. Next, to be punctual. Whenever you will go at an interview spot, to be punctual, because you have to adjust at a new place. According to that situation, you have to be punctual. And next, the most important point is switch off or silent, make your silent mobile. Because when you will give your interview, your mobile will be make disturbance in your interview, and that's why switch off and silent your mobile phone. Why should you go do interview? Why should you do interview? Why career is important in your life? First reason is that everyone wants independent life, and that's why independent is the main reason for career, for achieving career. A good career gives you an independent life. You don't have to be dependent on anyone. When you are earning, and it is one of the most important factors to be considered. Second reason is that secure life. Everyone wants a secure life. There is a sense of security. When you chose the right career, you can save money and live a secure life. A career not only fulfills your dreams and passion and provides your secure life. Third reason is that a career growth. Choosing the right career helps you grow in your career life. When you get success in career, you get a growth in your life. So for instance, you are choosing what you don't desire for doing the job only. Only for finance won't sustain you in job for the long run. And similarly, if you like, your career growth in the career is guaranteed. The next point is, next reason is that financial stability. With a good career, if you plan for savings, then it will also help you in financial stability. It is a source of financial stability, and that's why savings will only possible if you have a good career and a mind which looks for financial stability. Next is part of your identity. Part of your identity, if you got a career, you will get an identity in your life. Your career is a big time investment that will reflect your identity in the future. It plays a very important role in your lifestyle. Your social life will also be driven by a good career. Your choices for products and services differ after a good career. Next reason for getting a career is that provides direction. A good career will help you understand what you need in your life, and it will give you a clear direction towards your life. Many blurry pictures will be clearly visible to you. You will know that you will know what you want in your life and how to reach there. I have given you enough reasons why a good career is essential. Now you decide to make a wise move in your life for a better career. Next, there are so many characteristics of a successful interview, but first characteristics of a successful interview is a preparation. It has been said that well begun is a half done, and that's why you have to make starting for your preparation with positive mind, and that's why your preparation must be a very important role in your interview. Second is presentation. Your presentation must be impressive and attractive, because it throws the development of your personality, and that's why your presentation must be impressive and attractive. Next, third is content. When you will go interview, you have to know about the content, your subject, and draw expected questions, and according to that, prepare for that. and listen and hear all the previous videos which are based on interviews, and that's why your content must be clear before going to interview. Next, speak with confidence is a characteristic of a successful interview, because without a fluent speaking, you will not crack your successful interview. And that's why whenever you have to speak in interview or during interview, you speak with confidence. Next, speak clearly and consciously. Speak confidently but clearly. You interviewer can understand your answer clearly and consciously, and that's why you have to speak clearly and consciously. Project your voice so that you are heard. Make a voice clearly and don't speak in slow voice or too loud voice. Project your voice so that you are heard. What are the successful strategies for interview? Firstly, it has been said that first impression is the last impression, and that's why you have to make a strong first impression, including your personal rapport, smile, strong handshake, confident body language. Whenever you have to go interview, you have to make your first impression, and that's why including your personal rapport, smile, strong handshake, confident body language. And whenever you will enter in the interview room, you have to maintain your good eye contact, because if you will look down, it is a sign of a bad impact of on interview, and that's why make your eye contact goodly. Next, speak slowly and clearly. Whenever you will enter interview room, you have to speak slowly and clearly and give the answer of the questions which are asked by interviewer clearly and rightly. Clear idea of the key point. When interviewer will ask you about the ideas which are presented by you, please clear that idea of the key point. Next, be sure of your strength and how they apply to the job. Be sufficient but avoid yes, no answer. Don't you answer in yes or no, because your answer should be complete. Your answer should be complete and conscious and properly. And that's why be succinct but avoid yes, no answer. Be interested and enthusiastic. Whenever you will go interview, you should be hopeful and enthusiastic and interested in that subject which you will give interview. Before coming out of the interview hall, leave positively and say thank the interviewer. Main role is that participation of your interview. Participate in your interview means whenever you will go in interview hall, don't be go only by physically. Be present there mentally also, because if your mental status is absent at that time, your interview will not be make a successful. And that's why be honest and give complete answer. Be positive about yourself and past experiences. On the basis of your past experiences, you have to make your positivity in mind and make a positive about yourself. Don't linger in your mind negative thoughts. Next, avoid one or two words responses. Don't make a one or two word responses because avoid one or two word responses because the interviewer will be expecting to you in a complete answer and in a complete sentence, and that's why avoid one or two word responses. Give concrete examples. Whenever interviewer will ask you about the examples, please give the concrete examples and suitable examples which are related to your subjects. Next, paraphrase the question to avoid misunderstanding. Don't spread misunderstanding while giving your interview, and that's why you have to know about avoiding misunderstanding, and that's why don't make a misunderstanding with interviewer. Next, limit responses to 30 seconds. Whenever an interviewer asks you questions, there should be limit responses to 30 seconds. Don't take a long time for giving answer because interviewer will not be expect from you a long time, and that's why there should be limit responses to 30 seconds. Next point is that emphasize what you have to offer the company. Whenever you will go in interview hall, you should your personality should be emphasized to the interviewer, and you should emphasize what you have to offer the company. What is your dedication for company or organization or institution? Before going to interview, you have to maintain time management also. When you have to go on interview spot, arrive on time, because be on time, this means not only don't be late, but don't be too early and don't arrive late. Whenever you will reach, whenever you will arrive at an interview spot, keep patience to give interview, because there are so many persons who will come there to give interview, and that's why till your interview you have to maintain or keep your patience also, because there are so many candidates in that spot, and that's why you have to keep patience to give interview. After reaching at the interview spot, you have to maintain positivity in mind, because positivity gives you a powerful energy to give your interview, and that's why you have to maintain positivity in mind. Don't linger negativity in mind, and those and that's why you have to maintain positivity in mind. Body language is also a main part in interview, because body language reflects your personality development, and it is related to your personality, and that's why body language plays a vital role in interview, and that's why keep smiling and reflects your body language very impressively. Next, what should you do during interview? What should you do during interview? When you will enter interview hall, please give smile gently firstly, because if you are in the angry mood, it gives a bad impact on your interview, and that's why smile gently during interview firstly, and greet the interviewer and make a firm handshake to the interviewer, because it is a culture of Indian people to greet the interviewer or any people when you will meet to the other persons, and that's why greet the interviewer and firm handshake also. What should your body language should do during interview? What are the do's, or there are so many do's and don'ts. Primarily, I would like to tell you do's. Which are the do's related to body language? When you will enter in the interview hall or interview room, open good posture. Because if you have a fearful mind, if you have a fearful mind, you cannot express your presentation or views on that subjects, and that's why open your good postures very nicely. Maintain eye contact also positively. If you look down, it will be a bad impact on your interview, and that's why maintain eye contact confidently with others and interviewer also. Fifth main points is that listen carefully. Without accuracy in listening, you cannot give your interview successfully, and that's why you have to listen carefully and speak clearly also. Speak clearly means what are the questions will asked by interviewer, and speak clearly according to that questions. Be honest and confident. When you will enter in the interview hall take a seat before interviewer, be honest and confident. It has been said that honesty is the best policy, and that's why while giving answer, be honest and confident, because you are without your confidence, you cannot give your interview successfully. Relax but alert. After completing your interview, be relaxed but alert, because you don't know about the when interviewer will ask you and about anything, and that's why you should be relaxed but alert. Which are the don'ts related to body language during interview? First, don't limp and clammy handshake. Don't bring in carrier bags or clutter. Don't wear a tight dress. Don't look down. Don't cross arms. Don't flop into chair. Don't wave arms. Don't stare out of window. Don't shake with nose. Don't adopt a threatening posture. First is don't limp. Clammy handshake means don't make a limp and clammy handshake, and don't bring so many things with you in your carrier bags or clutter, and don't wear tight dress, because a tight dress will not be feel you comfortable, and that's why don't wear tight dress. And don't look down, because if you maintain your eye contact properly or confidently, it will be a good sign of your successful interview, and that's why don't look down. Make eye contact confidently and properly with interviewer. Don't cross arms. Cross arms means it shows the fearful mind of your, and that's why don't cross arm. And don't flop into chair. Don't linger your mind while sitting on the chair. Don't flop into chair, because it gives a bad impact on your interview. And don't wave arms. Whenever interviewer will ask you questions, don't wave your arms. Don't show your fearful mind to him. Don't stare out of window. See straightly to the interviewer. If you stare out of window, it shows a sign of your fearful mind, and that's why you have to make a contact and straight eyesight to the interior. Shake with nerves. Don't shake with nerves, because there are so many negative thoughts linger at that time in our mind, and that's why don't shake with nerves. Be positive and don't shake with nerves. Next is adopt a threatening posture. First time you have to maintain your posture. You have to open good posture, because our body language gives a reflection of our personality, and that's why don't adopt a threatening posture. Here I have given so many tips for interview. First is be confident, because without confidence you cannot express your views views and ideas perfectly and confidently, and that's why be confident but not be overconfident. Second is that keep a positive outlook. When you will go to interview, you have to keep a positive outlook also, because positivity gives us a powerful energy to crack a interview. Next is give a suitable responsible. Give a suitable response is a indication of a successful interview, and that's why whenever interviewer will ask you a question, give a suitable response to him, and cite relevant examples also. And when interviewer will ask you about giving examples, please give him relevant examples for that, and listen carefully also, because without a proper listening, you cannot give answer rightly or properly, and that's why listen carefully the questions of interviewer firstly, and then you answer properly. Look through the resumes. You have to look through the resumes. Don't be frightened at that time, because your positivity shows a good impression to the interviewer, and that's why you should be confident and look through the resume. After your interview, what should you do after interview? There are so many things which have to do after interview. First is thank the interviewer. When you will come out interview hall, before coming out interview hall, you have to thank the interviewer and offer a firm handshake and say nice to meet you, or glad to meet you, or pleasant to meet you. It is a formality, and that's why offer a firm handshake and say nice to meet you, or glad to meet you, or pleasant to meet you. Ask questions about salary, transport, vehicles, or facilities which you have want in your future life if you have selected there. Call back or send mails of inquiry. After your interview, after some days of your interviews, you have to make a call back or send mails of inquiry which candidates is selected there, and that's why you have to know about that, which candidate is selected there, and that's why you must call back or send mails of inquiry. If you selected, get ready for other rounds. If rejected, prepare for other job interviews, because don't become nervous if you rejected. Prepare for other job interview, because don't be nervous, because try but not try. Always remember the Hindi song, aayega aayega apna time aayega, and that's why don't be nervous and go ahead because in our life there are so many obstacles, but we have to go further because the show must go on. If you want to know extra information about the interview or communication skill, this is my book, The Importance of Communication in Modern Era, which is available on Flipkart and Amazon also. It is my book, and that's why you have to purchase it from Flipkart and Amazon also. And this book includes so many factors of communication skill, group discussion, interview skills, etc. Thank you for everyone, participants, because you attention to my live class lectures, and that's why you have to attend my lecture. For that, I'm very grateful to you, and I'm very grateful to all staff members of the English department for giving me such a golden opportunity to express my views here. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for such wonderful session with us. Now I would like to call upon Mr. Chauhan, sir, for the vote of thanks.
Okay. Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay, thank you, ma'am, for this wonderful session. It was really nice. Now I would like to propose a vote of thanks. Honorable dignitaries, distinguished guests, respected principal sir, and dear students, on the behalf of SBCT College Nagpur and its entire fraternity and the organizing committee, I feel immense pleasure to take this opportunity to propose a vote of thanks to our eminent speaker, Bhave ma'am, for contributory lecturer at SBCT College, who spared the time from her busy schedule to grace this webinar with her extremely relevant address on interview skills. She rightly talked about the importance of all the requirements that is essential for cracking any interviews. I will further extend Dr. Shinde sir, HOD of English, SBCT College Nagpur, for his guidance for this session. I take this opportunity to specially express my deep regards and gratitude to Dr. Sujit Maitre sir, Principal Sri Benjani City College Nagpur, for always encouraging us and providing opportunities to organize such events. I would specially thank our beloved Dr. Pranjali Kane ma'am, IQSE coordinator, SBCT College Nagpur, for her wonderful guidance and support and confidence in us. And my deep sense of appreciation and the thanks to all the participants who chose to be live with us and attend this session with us with a great enthusiasm and made it a successful event. My sincere gratitude also goes to the organizing committee, especially Bhave ma'am, Amrapali ma'am, Harsha ma'am, and all those who are working hard to make this event a success. I would also like to thank all the technical support, and I thank all the teaching and non-teaching staff who have worked hard to make this event a success. Once again, I thank you all for your patient listening. Thank you and have a wonderful day.
Thank you, sir.